Hello everyone, welcome to Morning English.
She's Blair. Hi guys, 欢迎大家收听早安英文。
She's Summer.
Hello, welcome to Morning English. 早安英文呢是一个为大家免费提供英语教学的频道，每天都会更新。如果你想获得关于英语听说读写的内容，我们都会在这个频道更新。我们的目标是帮助全球的华人学好英语。如果你觉得还不错的话，记得给我们订阅哦。另外，点开小铃铛，这样的话就不会错过其他任何学习视频啦。对了，如果你想获取本节课的完整版笔记，在视频简介或者评论区领取哦。你也可以给这个视频点赞，点赞就相当于自动保存啦。
Hey Summer, 作为一个专业的健身人士啊 ，Is there anything that you won't eat?有什么东西是你绝对不吃的吗
？Well, for fitness professionals, they do follow very strict diet, but I eat everything.
没有我们 Summer 不吃的东西啊。
没错。
那你觉得健身餐里面必不可少的一样食物是什么
？Well, I'm gonna go with beef. 我选牛肉吧。Beef is rich in protein, which can strengthen people's immunity. 牛肉呢，大家知道富含蛋白质，对于健身人士来说呢就很重要了。
Well, I like beef too. It's one of my favorite food. So maybe we can have beef together next time.
Well, we can have a steak together. But are you sure you want to have beef with me?
这个梗不错啊。Beef, 我们知道啊，最熟悉的含义就是牛肉了。不过啊，这个单词它可不仅仅是那么简单。It actually has many different meanings.
Yes. So for example, have a beef with someone. 其实不是啊，和某人一起吃牛肉的意思。
Yes. So have a beef with someone means to have an unsettled dispute or disagreement with someone. 跟某人啊，有没有解决的纠纷。Dispute, 表示争吵、纠纷的意思。
Yes.So, have a beef with someone, 就是呢和某人有过节、有争执的意思。
Right. For example, why does Summer have a beef with me? I'm always nice to her. Summer 怎么就老是跟我过不去呢？我对她很好啊。
So, told you, I don't have a beef with you. I'll have a steak with you.
哎，不过你发现没有，英文当中好多有趣的俚语啊，都跟食物有关系。
是的，这就让这些俚语变得更加有趣了。那在今天的节目里呢，我们就跟大家介绍一下这些实用又有趣的食物表达吧。So Blair, can you think of something right now?
Of course I can. That's not difficult at all. It's just as easy as pie.
哎，可以啊，现在这个知识点是无缝衔接。As easy as pie, 这个表达大家一定不陌生啊。It's used to mean that something is extremely easy and requires very little skill or effort. 就是非常简单，太简单了。
Yeah, for example, we can say the job was as easy as pie. We finished up an hour early. 这个工作、啊、太简单了，我们提前一个小时就完成了。
Yes, 说到这个 as easy as pie, 还有一个表达就不得不提了，也很像啊、嗯、然后意思也差不多，也和吃的食物有关。
Yeah, I know what you want to say, a piece of cake.、
Yeah.
It can also mean a very easy task or accomplishment.
Right, a piece of cake, 一块蛋糕就可以表示我们平常说的非常简单的事，易如反掌，或者是小菜一碟。因为像在西方国家，像蛋糕这样的甜点是必不可少的。吃一块蛋糕啊，简直太容易了。
嗯，
所以久而久之就有了 a piece of cake 这样一句表达。
Right. So here is another example. Well, I thought I was going to fail the test, but it turned out to be a piece of cake. 我以为我考试要挂了，没想到这次考试居然这么简单。
Right.哎，贝贝，你发现没有啊、
mm-hmm.
这些和食物相关的表达好像都还挺 easy 的。
刚刚那两个确实是 easy 了啊，因为看到这个表达呢，你大概就能猜到什么意思了。
Yes, but it's not always like that. And some idioms can be pretty confusing.
Okay, can you give us an example?
What about go bananas?
Go bananas, 这个也很简单啊，就是去吧香蕉。
你是想象自己是只猴是吧？
开玩笑啊。Go bananas, 这个表达虽然字面意思不太能猜出来，不过确实呢跟猴也有点关系啊。
没错，你像猴子看到香蕉啊，就像贝贝看到帅哥，
就像 Summer 看到美食。
We're all gonna go crazy.
Exactly. 所以 go bananas 就相当于 lose your mind or go out of one's mind, 表示啊要发疯了，要抓狂了。
Mm-hmm.
If you go bananas, you're wild with excitement or worry. 这个发疯抓狂可能呢是因为兴奋，也可能是因为生气。
Right, and also remember to use plural here. Go bananas, not go banana.
Right, go bananas. 一定要用复数啊，猴子们肯定也是有要求的，一根香蕉就不至于不至于了。
Right, right. Okay, so here's an example. Don't talk about math anymore. I'll go bananas. 不要再跟我提数学了，我快发疯了。
No, your math is so good. 你数学最棒了呀。And not just math.Summer is the best. Summer knows everything. Summer is the prettiest girl in the whole world.
Okay, okay, I see what you're doing here. Are you trying to butter me up for something? Because I'm telling you, I'm not buying it.
No, I just went bananas for you. 不过你说的这个 butter me up is exactly what I want.
Yeah, okay. Then let's take a look at this one. Butter somebody up.刚刚这个表达这里的 butter 就是黄油，在这里是一个动词，给什么东西抹上黄油。你看像中文中我们会说一个人嘴上像抹了油啊，抹了蜜一样，所以就是形容一个人说话很好听或者很会拍马屁。
Yes, so butter somebody up refers to someone who tries to say nice things to other people so that they will do what he or she wants. 这个表达呢也有称赞和奉承的意思啊，它呢可以是真心实意的夸奖，也可能呢是你有求于别人，这就要看自己结合语境来使用了。
Yeah, so here's an example. She really knows how to butter me up, saying all those good things about me. 她特别会来事儿啊，总是捡好听的话对我说。
Yes, or I know he's trying to butter me up, but I'm not buying it. 我知道他想要拍我马屁，但是我才不吃那一套呢。
对，还有一个单词就是刚刚贝说不吃那一套，这个单词其实也很实用，就用 buy 就好了。I'm not buying it.
Right.
Okay. And then, Blair, I'll tell you a secret. 快来快来，我想现在告诉你一个秘密，你把耳朵凑过来。
Okay. Okay. Wow, juicy.
Yeah.
What? I can't believe it.
Swear you're not gonna tell anybody. 你不可以跟任何人说啊。
虽然我们当着这么多的听众朋友们说了啊， but you've got to trust me. I won't spill the beans.
Okay, okay.刚刚这个表达很不错啊，值得学习一下，就是 spill the beans.
Right. 那这个表达是怎么来的呢？据说在古希腊的时候，有一些社团他们招收新成员的办法就是让老社员将豆子作为选票，赞成呢就投白豆，反对者就投红豆。那如果是装豆子的这个东西突然被打翻了，是不是能通过的这个决定啊就会被泄露出去，那大家呢也就提前知道结果了，所以后来 spill the beans 就有了泄露秘密说漏嘴这个意思。
That's right. So here's an example. It's a big secret. We should not spill the beans. 这个秘密非常重大，我们绝对不能泄露出去。
Spill the beans. 诶，那跟 beans 相关的表达还有一个啊， full of beans.它可不是只装满豆子的这个意思啊。
Yes, it means a lot of energy or enthusiasm. 在以前呢，豆子是最贵的马粮，因为它们可以给马提供很大的能量储备，所以这个 full of beans 就引申为呢精力十足的意思。
Right, 精力十足啊，就跟打了鸡血一样。So here is an example. The children were too full of beans. 孩子们精力太旺盛了。
Yes, or you can also say, you're looking full of beans, Blair.意思就是说啊，你这个人啊，精力充沛的。
Right. Okay, so today we've talked about food-related idioms. 今天就跟大家聊了跟食物相关的俚语表达啊。你还知道哪些呢？欢迎在评论区给我们留言哦。
那我们今天的节目就到这里啦。
Hello, welcome to Morning English. 早安英文呢，是一个为大家免费提供英语教学的频道，每天都会更新。如果你想获得关于英语听说读写的内容，我们都会在这个频道更新。我们的目标是帮助全球的华人学好英语。如果你觉得还不错的话，记得给我们订阅哦。另外，点开小铃铛，这样的话就不会错过其他任何学习视频啦。对了，如果你想获取本节课的完整版笔记，在视频简介或者评论区领取哦。你也可以给这个视频点赞，点赞就相当于自动保存啦。
Okay, so thank you so much for listening. This is Blair.
This is Summer. See you next time.
Bye. Bye.